Oh man, I haven't done this in a long time. I don't even remember when's the last time I did a channel update of just kind of talking about my life, what's been happening, what's been going on. Anyway, folks, this be David Kwan, and this be my most recent channel update. Actually, there are pretty big things to talk about since the last time I did this. The biggest thing, is that I'm no longer a student at NYU. I graduated. I now have a master's degree in social work, and that's been a long time coming. It's been quite a journey. To become a social worker was kind of the ambition I had 9 years ago. I came to New York City in 2006 to study social work. Didn't really have a full idea what that meant. Right, I read stuff about it before coming to New York because NYU told me to. Like, it was like they were like, oh, there are these two books. You need to read this and brush up on this before coming here and studying social work. I started coursework with like, what is social work? That was actually a class that I took, kind of detailed out all the various specialties and focuses of social work. Social work in hospitals, social work in schools, foster care, homeless shelter. Political work, although that wasn't as emphasized as much in our education. That's something that I came to become more aware of much, much later. But looking back, I think I had a more naive kind of viewpoint or version of what social work would mean to me. I always kind of followed this motto of improving the world one life at a time, that kind of cliche. I've come to have a more evolved perspective since with that, I don't really kind of see social work as, or what I want to do as that anymore. There is kind of an ambition in me to affect broader changes, or to really kind of to think social work more broadly than just kind of the clinical kind of idea of improving the world one life at a time or changing the world one life at a time. It doesn't necessarily have to be that, I think. And so that's kind of I'm here, and it's obviously though for those of you who kind of ended up on my channel or ended because of that really popular video of my student debt situation. Obviously, it hasn't been an easy journey, right? It started as a very spoiled, privileged kid. My mom, as a nurse in California, was making a lot of money. And so, like, there were life circumstances here and there that no one could predict. Although we probably, if we thought way deep ahead, hindsight is kind of a thing. We maybe should have or would have or could have predicted, I don't know. In any case, this is kind of how it ended up. 9 years, kind of, I see it as a continuous 9 years journey, although there were kind of brief breaks here and there, and there were certainly moments where I just thought, like, I need to give up on this kind of dream. Dreams are good, but it's not feasible or it's not realistic. It definitely were a lot of kind of negative kind of thinking there, or maybe more realistic thinking, depending on how you think it. There are definitely, like, a lot of times I looked at the comment section, like, yeah, you guys are right. This is stupid. Why did I spend so much money on this kind of path? Who would pay $100,000 or more, actually more for me, because of graduate degree, to get a degree that wouldn't really be a return investment, right? A lot of college degrees you think of as a return investment, and certainly wasn't really kind of, I don't think social work degree is where we think of a college degree in that manner. So, and much like how social work is not a liberal arts degree or a humanities degree, but I think people who go, for liberal arts or humanities don't really think of it as a degree for like a return investment. Like, I'm gonna get this degree to make this much more money going on. It's not the mindset I had. Going for social work, and maybe that's stupid for those of you who are more into economics and business or whatever. But that's not the mindset, the mindset is to follow the passion that I had, which was social work. And I think all through this time, I think my focus has kind of gotten broader and kind of got narrower and broader at the same time in a lot of ways. Now I kind of know exactly kind of what I want to do. With this degree, and going forward, I have kind of images of what it could look like 5 years from now, 10 years from now. There are a lot of possibilities here, but I have a kind of more clear ideas of what those possibilities can be. And so really my focus has been really been about preventing and reducing and if possible eliminating homelessness, particularly focused around homelessness in New York City. That's been a lot of my training and learning. But over the years, I think I've also kind of come to consider more homelessness in many other aspects and related fields such as mental health, the American prison system, immigration, LGBT rights, all those kind of myriad things that contributes to homelessness, and affordable housing policies and rent control policies, not only in New York City, but of course across the United States. And also, I've had some kind of considerations here and there in a more global context as well. So that's kind of been my journey to here. And it's been kind of challenging, but you see me in the suit. And of course, there has been a lot of videos where I, dressed up just to record a YouTube video. But this isn't one of those. This is actually my work clothes. I finished my first week as a social worker this week. I've been recently hired. My job title is actually social worker, which I feel so giddy about. It's a pretty amazing feeling to have an ID card that says staff. There's my picture, and right underneath, that there's my job title, social worker. It's been 9 years, but it still feels like, whoa, this feels quite too soon. I expected a lot more toil and suffering to get to this point, but I'm here. I mean, that's not to say that the title is that important, right? I really think the profession as broad and inclusive as I can. I think there are jobs where there's social work, whatever, that word is not there, right? You can be a case manager, supervisor, a consultant, a clinician, a therapist, policy analyst, director of a shelter, a U.S. congresswoman, or something like that, where your job title doesn't have social worker, community organizer, activist, and I think you can still be a social worker. And I think it's a very broad profession of really kind of working towards societal betterment and empowerment of individuals and families and groups and kind of doing that. I think that's what social work is really all about, and that's been my passion. And I'm so glad to finally be at this point where I can don't really have to worry about paying rent, making my loan payments. Although I have some grace period, of course, before I have to start making my loan payments again. And it's always been my intention. If you've watched any of my videos about this, about the loan thingy, I know a lot of comments kind of missed that point a lot, but my point has never been about like, oh, this is so unfair, I'm gonna like, whatever. It's really been about kind of like, this is my situation, and this is kind of what I've been dealt with. And this is, I kind of knew it going in, and whatever. Do I regret it? Yes and no, right? There's, I think, whatever. So that's that, and so I've never defaulted on any of my loans. And it's gone from here to down back there, and now it's back up because of graduate loans and whatnot. But I calculated my expenses. I've been able to eke out kind of living here in New York City somehow with a salary that is half my current salary, or maybe a little over half, but it was compared to many other master's level professions. Definitely my job salary is quite horrible, considering comparatively speaking, but for me, it's enough. I feel quite comfortable with this. And there are definitely going to be much more challenges ahead. It's not going to be all happy and gooey now that I'm working as a social worker or whatever. And it's a challenging profession. It's not like it can be stressful and whatnot. It's it is a profession that kind of cater towards those who are the most ignored, the most hated, and the most vulnerable populations of society, right? And so that's kind of the work itself, and all the while being underappreciated, underpaid, overworked, you know, I know that going in. And so this is not a profession that people go in thinking like, oh my gosh, I do this, I'm going to make tons of money and feel good about myself. Not necessarily the case. It can be the case, but it might not be the case either. And a person like me knows that going in. It's not like I don't know that going into this field. But I'm very excited about this particular opportunity that I have. When I focused on homelessness throughout this whole past 9 years, it's been an interesting gamut of things. I worked at a homeless shelter. I worked with a community organizer that kind of was all about organizing around affordable housing and protecting the rights of tenants who are getting evicted or about to be evicted, things like that. And also preventative work too, right? Street outreach and rental subsidy policies and kind of those things of the nature. But now I'm doing work that's kind of totally different, but related to that and the homeless services world, and that's really exciting. The work that I get to do now is it's a startup program, so we're still in the development phase of things. It's very slow going. Right now it's kind of really boring work of just being behind a computer screen, drafting documents, making templates, having brainstorming sessions with staff, a lot of trying to develop a database, a lot of Excel spreadsheet work. Very boring stuff. I mean, I've had some interviews here and there, interview work here and there, but mostly right now it's that kind of stuff, which I still am very excited by because of my most recent internship where I did a lot of that. You know, my most recent internship was at a government city agency. My supervisor was one of the top executives of that agency, so I got to do a lot of policy analysis and revision work, that kind of thing. So now I'm at this stage, and it's very exciting to be thinking about helping people who were homeless for year or longer, and now they have an apartment of their own. That's kind of the population that, the organization I'm working also is providing that opportunity for homeless people to be able to get that kind of support and that, you know, have their place of their own and no longer be homeless, have permanent housing. That's where I'm at right now, to be a social worker for that. And it's something that I've never really thought about being in, but it's a opportunity that has risen to me, and it's really exciting. And I think this is a pretty big contrast to my year right after I graduated bachelor's. There's a big difference between now when I graduated with master's degree. I think the biggest difference is that with my bachelor's, I wasn't really able to make good professional connections or relationships, you know, the so-called networking thing. I didn't really do much of that, and I've learned now that that's like so important. And I have a professor. You know, there was an award ceremony that I was given an award by my school pretty recently. And that award ceremony, one of my professors came to it, and really just we developed this really awesome kind of mentor-mentee relationship. He gifted me a book, actually. I'm reading through it, and this is such an amazing book. He became one of my references, and a really amazing connection that kind of allowed me to kind of really do a good job or be connected to interviews and do good jobs in interviews, and probably like one of the big reasons I got hired here, right? And so even in my internships, I've come to have really good professional relationships with the executives, the managers, become friends with them. I still keep in touch with them, even though I work in a totally different agency now. We still share emails with each other, and I might even have dinner in the near future with a team of staff members that I used to intern for. I think that's the biggest difference here now. I mean, When I got my bachelor's, I was applying to all these places and never heard anything back. When I got my master's, or in the process of master's, I didn't really apply to that many places, but I got a lot of responses, and I'm pretty surprised at the interviews that I was able to kind of be scheduled for. And so I felt kind of, like, I guess a little bit arrogant in a way. I tried to kind of hold myself at bay. I felt more confident, although still nervous myself. But yeah, that's been what's up so far. I don't think it's gonna be all kind of happy and positive like this whole video has been. I do definitely expect a lot of challenges, a lot of struggles, a lot of frustrating moments in the near future and onwards. And there's definitely gonna be lots to share about that. Although in a manner that doesn't, violate the kind of confidentiality policies that I have to abide under as a social worker. There's a lot of secrets here that I have to keep. A lot of people's stories and organizational stories that I can't share. Otherwise, I'd be sued and fired, right? So, and it would be very unethical of my professional code. So that's always something I try to keep in mind as I also keep a very public presence on YouTube, on Facebook, on Twitter, whatnot. It's definitely a balancing act. But anyway, that's my update. I hope you guys are glad that I have a very positive. This has been a very positive update so far. Let's see what happens going forward. Cheers.